What type of what kind of hate are you against?
All forms of hate against all forms of people and everyone.
Like what, for example?
Well, we're against hate towards immigrants and hateful rhetoric towards immigrants and refugees, like we hear coming from the president so often lately. That is something we're absolutely against as Christians.
And when you say immigrants, you mean illegal aliens?
I mean immigrants of all types.
How about the illegal aliens?
People who are undocumented, absolutely. Yes, they're God's children, the same as documented Americans.
What makes you think that they are God's children? They have all types of diseases. They bring violence. They have out of wedlock children. They come here, especially free stuff. To start the life of America. Well, what makes you think that they are God's children?
That could be said of anybody who's in any country.
But that's true about the illegal aliens. Why do you call them God's children?
Of course they're God's children.
What made them God's children?
The refugee in the caravan coming over from Central America is the same before God as I am or you are. Anyone who in America who's documented, there's nothing special about being I'm American, and so that means I'm more of God's child than that person. That's
not scripture. But what made these dirty people that come here illegally God's children?
Well, I would first of all debate the fact that they're dirty.
Yeah, they're full of diseases and crimes and drugs.
That's just not true.
Out of wedlock birth, all kinds of stuff. And right now they're at the borders of Tijuana and Mexico and San Diego, and it's been reported they're brought in all kinds of diseases.
Well,
they're getting
sick.
I'd like
to see that report.
And they're not wanted in Tijuana either.
I'd like to see that report, like, that proves that, because I've seen reporters in there with a lot of these people, and they're just trying to flee crime. They're trying to flee poverty. You know, Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, they were at one point refugees going into Egypt.
If they're trying to flee all those things, why didn't they stop in other countries before reaching to America? Why didn't they stop in El Salvador or Mexico or one of those countries? Why did they walk right through to come here if they are truly trying to flee crime and all that?
Well, we're supposed to be the city that's on a shining hill, right? I mean, America's supposed to be the Statue of Liberty, a place people come for hope and for help, for mercy. I hope that we become that again, because that's what made America great, is that we were a country that it said, you know, give us, you're tired, you're poor. That was what made America great. I hope we get back to that after
Why
Trump.
Why didn't they stop off in Mexico if they're fleeing violence?
I don't
Why
really,
did they pass through Mexico to here?
I don't know all the answers to every single case. All I know is that this is a humanitarian crisis.
But it's not humanitarian because they're not fleeing a war or anything. They're just coming here for free stuff.
Oh, that's not true.
No, it's
no,
true.
They're coming here. If you hear the folks talk, and I've talked
but
to some
liars.
Of these people.
They're not honest people. They're breaking the law, so they're liars anyway.
Well, if that's the case, then you could say the same for your president, because he breaks the law and he lies. He's lied over 4,000 times.
Are you referring to the Great White Hope?
okay. First of
are
all...
Are you referring to him, though, the Great White Hope?
Well, okay... First of all, I want to know why it matters that he's a white hope, and then I want to know who he's a hope for.
Right.
I'm asking you, like who is he? Who does he represent hope for?
Well, first of all, are you referring to the Great White Hope?
I'm referring to Donald Trump.
Okay, the Great White Hope.
Yeah.
He loved America first. He loved the world, but he's a nationalist, so he put the country first. First time I've seen that happen in my lifetime on this earth. Is it wrong for the president to put the country first?
Well, I don't think that nationalism is a good thing. No.
Why not?
We've seen where that ends up.
Are you
history.
A nationalist?
No.
What are you? Are you a communist?
No.
Are you a socialist?
No, I'm not.
What are you if you're not a nationalist?
I'm a progressive. I'm a Democrat.
How can you be a progressive and be a Christian?
Well, I think that Jesus was a progressive.
Why do you think that about Jesus?
Absolutely. He came and he changed the order of things. He came and he brought a new message, and he brought a new kind of hope and a new message of love. And if you look at what Jesus talked about the least of these, I mean, he said, give them the shirt off your back. If they ask for your tunic, give them your cloak also. I mean, that was the message of Jesus. He
said,
welcome the stranger.
He came for salvation. These people are not being saved by breaking the law to come here and forcing their way into our country. Would you agree?
Well, they're not breaking the law by asking for asylum. That doesn't break
but
the law.
But they are. They're trying to cross the fence. They're attacking the border patrol.
Well,
they're doing everything.
There were a couple that were throwing some rocks.
Yeah,
I don't think that constitutes as an attack. I mean, this entire process by the president has made the process illegal, because there is a legal process for coming and asking for asylum.
For refugees. These are not refugees.
Well, they are.
No, some of these women just walk across the border and they drop the baby across the border and call anchor babies.
Oh.
And the baby, and they become citizens. You think that's fair?
I think it's a mischaracterization.
No, it's true.
I think that's part of the propaganda that's going out about people who are just coming for hope and are just desperate
for a chance. It hope when they come and suck the life out of our social system? These illegal alien mobs are sucking the life out of our system.
Immigrants pay taxes, even those that are undocumented.
No, they don't pay taxes.
If you look at communities that have a high rate of immigrants, undocumented or not, those communities thrive. If you look at the
statistics.
Because
they get all this free stuff.
No, because they're paying taxes, and they're also taking jobs Americans don't want. So we do need reform. I agree with you there. We need reform, but it needs to be the whole system, and it needs to be compassionate. As a Christian, I think reform needs to be mercy first and compassion.
Do you agree that these illegal aliens are breaking the law by coming here?
No, they're not. Presenting yourself for asylum and asking, that is our lawful
process.
But when
they break into the country, that breaks the law.
Breaking in, if they're not actually asking for asylum and going through those channels, the thing is,
the law at that point?
Well, the whole system is a mess. I mean, it's breaking, there's so many things that could be constituted as, oh, this is breaking the law. I mean, our system needs reform, because there aren't channels to go through. People say, go get in the back of the line.
There's
no
line. They can come through the front door.
They're trying. That's
the
point.
These illegal mobs are breaking the law because they're lawless people. They're nasty, dirty people.
I actually don't agree. I believe that as a follower of Christ, it's our mandate to go. We're actually going to the border. We're going to the border next Saturday, going to San Diego. We're taking our own caravan of Christians out there to help these people, to give them food.
So you're helping the illegal aliens?
We're helping the refugees.
Are you helping them to break the law to come here?
No, there are churches on the border right now that are helping and doing what Jesus said to do, which
but
is
Jesus
to welcome the stranger.
But Jesus would not be happy with those so-called Democratic Christians because they're not real Christians.
Well, that's not.
Because a real Christian is not a progressive, not a Democrat, not a liberal.
Well,
a real Christian
is a
conservative person.
Well,
that's
very judgmental, though. I think that it's very judgmental to judge someone based on their political affiliation.
No, they're not real Christians. They're fake Christians.
Well, that's very judgmental.
What do you mean?
Well, no one can judge. Jesus spent
an
entire...
But you're judging the president. You judge the Great White Hope for putting the country first. Well, how are you able to judge?
No, I'm not judging him based on that. I'm judging because he lies.
But you're not supposed to judge him at all.
And because he doesn't put the needs of the least of these first. And in fact, every tenet and every value of Jesus Christ that I know of as a Christian, as I read my Bible, he's broken. He's not standing by.
What did the president, the Great White Hope, lie about?
Can I just ask, though, I really want to know, why is he, who is he a hope for?
He's hope for the country. He put the country first. He's hope for the American citizens first. He's hope to the blacks, because for the first time in years, the blacks are finally working again. The women are working now. He's hope for the family. He's hope for the country. He's hope for everybody. We have not had this before.
Wow. That's an interesting take.
And so what did he lie about? You call him a liar.
Yeah, he's lied over 4,000 times on
about
record.
About what?
Do we have time to go through 4,000?
We have time for at least two or three.
Sure. I mean, he's lied about the investigation over and over and over.
What investigation?
The Mueller investigation.
He has lied. There's been no proof of collusion.
He lies about
the president nor Russia. So that hasn't been a lie.
He lies about the media. He lies every single day. He's lied about whether he paid off a porn star.
How did he lie about the media?
He calls them the enemy of the people, and
he
calls things fake news that is actual real facts.
The liberal media is the enemy.
Well, there is no
of the people.
Quote, I will agree there's a left-wing media and there's a right-wing media.
Right.
But the media, and that's mostly political commentators, and you can disagree or not agree. But the media who is actually promoting and telling the truth, that's democracy. And we need them right now because what's coming out of this White House is propaganda.
No, that's not true.
It's all propaganda.
You didn't give me any proof of that at all. You just said about Russia collusion, there's no proof of that at all.
He lied about Stormy Daniels. He's lied about Puerto Rico.
But utterly Stormy Daniels
about,
a whore. She's a slut. You support the slut?
But he's not.
Do you support the slut?
No, I'm asking, are you
She just said that her lawyer tried to rip her off, too.
Yeah, I saw that.
Yeah. And
I
even
no
her own lawyer, according to her, tried to rip her off.
But
why would you believe a slut?
But she's not the point. The point
she's
is...
a slut.
Okay.
Why would you believe a slut?
Why is Donald Trump not a slut?
Because he doesn't slut around.
He's the one who had an affair with the porn star and then
paid off. If that happened before he became president.
And then sent his minions out to get
Have you
her.
Ever slutted around?
No, I haven't.
You never slut around?
No.
Have you ever slept with a man that you weren't married to?
Why are we talking about me?
That's
Why are we talking about me right now?
Because you're judging the president and you're judging the horse face.
God.